so wonderful. Spending time with the moronic staff of hanging out. And this is a question I want you to ask yourself. Can your pussy walk? Can your pussy talk? Can your pussy smile? Can your pussy frown? Can your pussy...
That was the artist formerly known as Brent, but if you'll just stay modest for a moment, I'd like you to give this man a standing ovation because it was astonishing. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Iggy, are you a modest man?
You can't ask a guy a question like that.
Okay,
you know,
I won't ask that question. But did you take that as a compliment?
Yeah.
Because it certainly was. There's a lot of people broken out into a bit of a sweat over that performance. But anyway, now on this show, we've had some of the finest stars. We've had Helena Christensen, Claudia Schiffer, Andre Agassi, Green Day, rock and roll great, supposedly. But none more important than this man. So listen, if you've got a question, get calling. Because are you willing to answer questions
today? I love that sort of thing.
Yeah. Excellent. You can interrogate this man, and he's looking forward to it. Now, I like to keep fit and trim. Not a chance. Basically, I like to keep fit and trim. I've been watching this man, I've been trying to put on a bit of bulk, and I discovered the all-time video to do this to. The tune you might have heard, it's called La Macarena, but some bright spark has come up with the idea of getting fit to it. Confused? Find out more now. Iggy.
Yeah.
I was at the show yesterday. I saw you perform, and I can't help notice your dance steps are, you know, there's a bit of similarity going on. Now tell me, have you been watching the Macarena Masterclass in
private? Don't get cheeky.
Okay. Don't get cheeky. Good manners. Now listen, do you know who this is?
No.
This man is called Gary Barlow. He used to be in this small band called Take That. Did someone cheer Take That in the same? Okay, good, well done, excellent. Now, if you stick around, you might be finding out some interesting news about him later, so that's important. Anyway, yesterday at the concert, Sex Pistols, there was another band, another current favourite of mine. They are called Skunk Anansie. We'll be hearing a song from them later, and personally I think you'll be blown away. But if you at home are a little confused and don't know enough about this man, then A, you've either been living with your eyes closed for most of your life, or B, you should watch this.
Spider sitting in the corner, gonna catch a fly. The web is pulling tight around it.
The real wild child Iggy Pop started his life in the music business as the drummer for the Iguanas in 1962. 8 albums and 34 years later, he's still going strong and living life to the full.
And the only way to go is to find, is to find.
His 1970s tracks Lost for Life and Nightclubbing featured on the soundtrack of the film Trainspotting, and he has appeared in several films himself, including Tank Girl, The Crow, and The Color of Money with Tom Cruise. But acting is only a sideline. Iggy's passion will always be music.
I'm giving up my soul to belong.
An icon of American cool Iggy Pop is a one-off. Artistically, he looks up to Bowie, Jim Morrison, and Lou Reed, but he's a legend in his own way. Join us today as he hangs out with us.
So Iggy, it's been a long time, from Lust to Life to the present day, Naughty Little Doggy, blinding album. Have you felt your music's changed?
I don't know, I never listen to it after I get it done.
Excellent.
I just do them and move on.
Stick around, I'll give you a tape of it later. A lot of it's pretty good.
I won't listen to it.
You won't listen to it. God. Right, anyway, listen, we've got a caller for you. His name's John, he's in Germany, and I think he's there. Hello, John.
Hi, Iggy.
Hey, John.
All right, dude, how's it going, mate?
I'm doing all right.
All right. I've got a few questions for you. Right, the first one...
You're not a German. You're British.
No, I'm British, mate. It's pretty obvious, isn't it?
That's okay.
But I think he's in Germany. True?
Yeah, that's right.
Blinding. Carry on.
Okay, mate. Right. Hey, you're good mates with David Bowie, aren't you? Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay. I was just wondering, have you ever considered doing a concert with him? Because a concert with you and David Bowie would be absolutely awesome.
I couldn't understand what you said, John. Say it again.
I'm sorry. Have you ever considered doing a concert with David Bowie?
I've done a few. I mean, I just played with him the night before last in Germany.
All right.
John,
but you weren't there.
John?
Yeah?
Where were you? Yes, exactly. That's what we're thinking.
I feel very bad about that. Alright.
John?
Alright, next question. You just ruined all my questions because they're all about your concert.
There's another one in Germany in 2 days, this Friday on the 28th in Halle near Leipzig with the two of us and Ash as well.
Oh, blinding.
We're supposed to be a good band.
Okay, thank you very much for that.
Okay, man.
Excellent. John, take it very easy.
I'm trying.
Truly brilliant. Another MTV moment. You're welcome. Now listen, I was in the Iceland concert only on Friday. And he was performing one of your songs, Lust for Life.
Yeah, he said he's doing it, yeah. Well, that's good. I mean, he wrote it with me, so it's fair game.
So you'll do it and he'll do it, but each of you.
The more the merrier. A lot of people do that song.
Excellent.
Now it's 20 versions or something.
Yeah, so. Do you like people covering your songs?
Well, yeah.
For what reasons?
I get paid.
Excellent! Crispin asked yet another stupid question on MTV. You're most welcome to it. Now listen, as I was saying earlier, they were playing on the same headline as you, on the same bill as you last night. Their name's Skunk and Nancy, and boy, has that girl got a voice. This is Charity. I think if you stick around, you might be seeing some more bullfighting later. Now, we've just, Nikolai was mentioning the facts from Harry in Finland, who was saying the Provence Rock 96 in Finland was full chaos and playing good old rock and roll. That's quite touching, isn't it?
They had fun playing for them.
Was it good?
Yeah.
Good crowd?
Sure, they're a bit off the beaten track. They appreciate an effort, I think.
Well, it's always good to stroll off the beaten track, so they say. Now, listen. Also off the beaten track, this weekend, England witnessed the reformation of the Sex Pistols, and you were on the headline with them as well. How did that gig go? A, for you, and B, how do you think it went for them?
I thought it was a good day and night in general. I wouldn't have been there if I hadn't thought it would be
of
quality.
So when it was offered to you, did you jump at the chance?
Jump's a strong word.
Excellent. But, you strolled towards the chance.
It was a good thing to be on. I respect the band. I always thought they were a good band, so, yeah.
And how do you think they pulled it off this time? Because there are a lot of very cynical people.
I thought they played very well.
Excellent, me too.
Yeah, it was rocking.
It was rocking. And what's more, whilst we're here, we must give a shout out to Stuart, the Scottish security man, because he personally got me out of a very sticky problem, all right? So can you just say Stuart, respect?
No, that's your...
Stuart, respect. Okay. Anyway, now listen. In the news, we've got a piece about the Sex Pistols, so stick around for that. Keep calling, questions for Iggy, and I think we've got a phone call. Is there Sarah from Germany?
Hi.
Hello, Sarah.
Yeah, hi.
Hello. Now, listen, I have a God sitting beside me. Speak to him.
Okay. Hi, I want to know which kind of book you read.
That got a bit cut up. Ah, Iggy, what kind of books do you read?
Sarah, it's a kind of a mix with me. Right now it's Milan Kundera, The Book of Laughter and Forgetting. He's Czech or Hungarian.
Czech.
Is he Czech? Yeah. I usually read what Martin Amis puts out, and I read a lot of old stuff, just your standard. Victor Hugo, Dickens. I read Gibbon's Decline and Fall, history, a lot of stuff.
Do you think it's good to read?
I think it's very helpful. I don't really read John Grisham, anything like that, or airport books.
Well done.
I think too much can become an escape. I tend to want to know what I'm getting out of this for my time.
Right.
So
have any books actively influenced your music?
Well, only in the corny way that there have been times in my life when I was not doing as well as I am now, and I remember in the 70s I read a book called The Godfather, and I got very inspired and basically felt, okay, I'm going to go out and be the King Godfather.
Excellent.
And sometimes things like that can happen for you, you know.
Well, listen, I personally, I've read that as well, and it did me a lot of good. Sarah, I hope that answered your question. Stick around after the break. We've got a whole heap of things, including news, more Macarena, and adverts. Goodbye. Iceland to London, 5 minutes. What do you reckon?
I like crisp.
Thank you. That was exhausting. Thank you, Toby. Thank you very much, Toby. Truly astonishing news piece there. And if you want to see more of Toby, Alternative Nation at every Tuesday, midnight, Central European time. Stay in touch because he's a later day genius. Now, phones have been flooded, Iggy. And now we have Mike from England who has, I'm sure, utterly relevant question. Hello, Mike.
Hiya.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Excellent. I'm particularly well, but I'm sure you don't want to speak to me, so let me hand you over to the man himself.
All right, Iggy.
Hey, man.
How do you feel about your music being used on the train soundtrack?
I liked it because they didn't with it. They just let it play all the way and didn't cut it. It's great, yeah.
Yeah, it was great. Did you see the film before?
Yeah.
What do you think of it?
Thought it was a travelogue for heroin use.
Yes. So, well, in that case, good point. Mike, I hope that
No, I mean, that's just what it is. I'm not saying it's good or bad. It's a very good, very well done film.
And you actually met the writer of that, didn't you?
Yeah.
Irvin Welsh.
Yeah, I'm going to meet the director the day after tomorrow as well.
Excellent. I hope, would you ever consider being on his next film?
Well, sure, I do that sort of work.
Excellent.
Time to time.
So. What, film work?
Yeah.
Well, I think that might be relevant to our next caller, because we've got Valentina in Italy. Valentina!
Hello!
Ciao, bella ragazza!
Hi, Valentina.
How are you, Valentina?
I can hear you very well.
Excellent!
We said hi.
Anyway, I want to say hi to Iggy Pop, and I'd like to thank him, because I wrote him a letter a few years ago, and he kindly replied. I don't know if you remember about that.
I don't remember the particular one. Where are you from?
I'm from Milan, from Italy.
I'm playing in Milan on the 29th.
Yes, I know, and hopefully I will be there.
Oh, I hope you come. I hope I see you.
Okay.
Okay, cool.
Valentine, have you got a question for the man?
Well, the question is if I'm going to pursue my career in...
How's your music career and film career progressing?
I don't know. It's, you know, I don't think of it that way, really. I just kind of do the stuff as it comes up. It's just like talking to God, isn't it?
Oh, excellent. Word on the street is that it's going quite well.
But it's nice. It's nice you called.
Okay.
It's nice to hear your voice.
Okay. Yeah, I know because it sounds very different. That's
good
with the voice.
Cool.
Okay. So I hope.
I hope I see you.
Valentina, take it easy. Iggy, what was your last film?
The Crow 2.
The Crow 2.
That's not out yet. The last one that's out is Dead Man, Jim Jarmusch.
What do you play in it?
Transvestite Cowboy.
Transvestite Cowboy. did you enjoy the role?
I did.
Excellent.
I liked the bonnet very much.
Did you get to keep it?
I kept the bonnet, yes.
Excellent news. God, yes. They're generous in the film industry. Yes. Now listen, we've got another caller. His name is Simon, and guess what? He's in England. Hello, Simon.
Hello.
How are you?
All right. Afternoon, James.
Hi, Simon.
Just a question, mate. Of all the albums you've done, including one for the Stooges, which is your favourite?
I don't really think that way. I mean, I just don't think that way. The one that's closest to me, that's kind of most homemade and closest to the live set, is Funhouse.
Yeah.
I don't know if that means it's better or not, but that's just an exact homemade representation of what you would have seen live at the time. La-da-dee-da.
Yeah, I know, Funhouse is one of my favourites, actually. But don't you think it's about to end in a book as well, about your life and that? Make a good read, wouldn't it? You've been a bit wild in your youth, haven't you?
Are you saying you like the book I wrote, or you're asking me if I've written one?
If you're going to write one, you know, like an autobiography.
I wrote one about 15 years ago. It's still around. It's a little hard to get. But I don't think I'll write any more like that.
Like that?
Do you think the 15 years since then merit another autobiography?
No. I'd rather move on and try to write fiction. It's just a bit more involved.
So can we expect that?
If I can handle the form. Yeah.
Best best of luck. Now, I know you've got to rush off because you've been nice enough to pull another song.
Yeah, I'll play another song.
So get ready. Thank you. You are all heart. Now, listen, if you stay watching MTV later...
Yeah.
We've got this show called...
Even if I watch MTV?
I know you do.
Dream on.
Oh. Well, listen, if you make an exception to the rule, there's a show called Stylissimo, and they've introduced this new form of underwear. Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's called the Wonder Bum Pant. And have a little look at this. You might be convinced. Do you think Iggy needs a pair? Iggy!
Yeah.
What do you think of the uplifting bum pants?
I wasn't paying attention.
Have a look. Have a look. Have a look. They're great, aren't they?